incorporate something inside you, that is a valid phenomenon there in occultism. So occultism deals with a lot of things. Mantra, yantra, tantra, yoga, yaga, lot of things. These things are just encompassed into the form of occultism. There we are going to take something known as bioenergy. I have to explain what is bio. I have to first explain also what is healing. I have to also explain what is energy and various positional status of energy. You know that bio, generally bi means two, and bio is just a prefix that deals with the bifurcated species of survival. They are the plant species and animal species. Basically sthavara and jangama, we used to say. Most of these species, they incorporate the society, the cosmic society. And bioenergy, naturally in its peripheral status, it means any type of energy evolved by these things for interaction. For example, number one, the energy that is revealed by the botanical sources, the impact of botanical sources on human life. Number two, the impact of other subservient animal sources like insects are there, worms are there, then amphibia, then we have apes, we have pieces, we have mammalia. So that inferior or infrasentient species, their influence. Number two, influence of human beings on botanical sources. Influence of human energy on animal sources. Four. Number five, influence of animal on, that is a particular thing, on its own sources. It is homogenetic reflection, we used to say. HGR, homogenetic reflection. Influence of animals for their own symbiosis. Influence of plants for their own development amongst themselves. And influence of human being for the welfare of the co-denizens of the human society. And influence for the human being for the celestial society. Aradhana is for God, and Pujana is for the Devatas, and Tarpana is for the Rishis, Rishi Pitru Devatas. So this is the interaction between the celestials and human beings. And human God interface, actually I told. So all of these things, they will come under bioenergy. That is botanical human impact. Then animal human impact, botanical impact, zoo animal impact, human impact, human botanical and animal impact naturally, human celestial impact, celestial human impact, human transcendental impact, and transcendental human impact are the varieties of bioenergy sources. If you want to read bioenergy, you have to classify the family of bio, and we have to deal with all of these things. There is also one more bioenergy. Even though there are non-living beings in the world, those insentient forces of nature, they do have a course of reflection in human life, and human life, they used to have, it is known as ecosymbiosis, in which there is also a type of life in nature that is known as receptive consciousness. Considering the rudimentary substratum of philosophy, which says that everything is life and everything has life or impact of life on it, we have to take also consideration of non-living forces of nature and their impact on human life and human beings' impact on the ecosystem. That is the eco-anthropic system and the anthropo-ecological systems, we used to say. So everything must be studied separately with their mutual reality, relativity and reliability and practicality for getting an idea about the bioenergy sources. Number one, it is just an formal introduction to various sources of bioenergy. And second thing, let us explain what is energy. Energy, you know that each and everything is having its own function. The driving element of each and every function is known as energy. Is the nature, there are three words I have to explain before getting into this energy. Energy, force and power. Energy, force and power. That is the nature of an element acting on it. That nature of element, when it acts on us, then that is metamorphosed into a process of functional ability. Then functional ability creates an impact. Let me just clearly explain it once more for getting better understanding. There is a nature of an element. The nature of element acts on a second element or a dependent element. It creates a response, and the response creates an impact. So the nature of an element is known as force. And that force, that driving force, that creates some sort of energy in the secondary element. If this energy creates an impact in the society or impact in any destination, that is known as power. For example, if I am feeding you knowledge, it is force of knowledge getting inside you. If you feel the knowledge within you, that is known as the energy of knowledge. if you apply it and create an impact, that is known as power of knowledge. So force, energy and power, you have to understand very clearly. Most of the people believing in God, they are suffering because they do have the force of God either being instructed, implemented, inculcated, initiated or tutorially embedded inside by any teaching sources, either referential, deferential or reverential sources and their influence. But mere force is inadequate. That must constitute some energy out of your realistic companionship and it must be made as a power. For example, you know that there is force of water. The force of water towards a specific direction creates the hydral energy. If it is properly channelized and affixed with a generator device, then it becomes hydral power. So most of the people, we do have belief in God. Belief in God must be changed to force of divinity, force into energy of divinity. When we reach the power of divinity, that is going to work, and all the other things are just initial steps for reaching the power, and they don't come for rescue. Most of the people merely think that their belief or love towards God itself is power, and they are disappointed whenever things are not properly happening as per their expectation and dreams. So there is a process. For example, more than the rich people, the poor, they believe and they aspire for money more. But mere aspiration, why they are suffering? Mere aspiration and desire for money or emergent need for wealth, that is not going to solve them. They want the power of wealth. Power of wealth is based on acquisition skills. That is to be developed. Likewise, here energy, it is contributed by force, by any extra force, or it may be an internal force acting upon us. So before talking about energy, one must clearly understand that there is a previous step to energy, that is force. And the basic spirit that distinguishes the force is your enthusiasm and your attention and your belief. There are three requisites. You must be having that enthusiasm, and apart from enthusiasm, you must be attentive and you must be totally concentrative on the process. And the next step is you must have a deep-rooted faith for having the fructification of the both. These are all the previous steps to raise into force, and after force only we are getting into energy, directly getting into plus two intermediate, directly getting into doctorate. This is not going to happen for all. The previous step of energy is force. Before that, you must have the basic concrete foundation known as belief, in which you have to erect the pillars of attention and curiosity or enthusiasm. Then after energy also, you have to convert into power. These techniques are to be taught. And this is a very conducive atmosphere. See, that is known as a positional ambience. There are 100 types of ambiences. Eco ambience is there, theo ambience is there, bio ambience is there, pico ambience is there. Likewise, we are having some sort of eco ambience here, and also positional ambience, that is physical ambience is there. Barabhan and Acharya are anybody who interprets or who flows or charges the person with his immaculate wisdom, he must be seated in this position. In Yathartasana, Vajrasana or Padmasana, when that position is there. For example, if somebody, we have to positionally adjust ourselves as per our requirement, we know that. If something is, for example, if you want to take something from a tree, then you are just jumping. To take something from the ground, nobody is jumping, they are just bending themselves and taking that. Depending upon the availability, their position or posture that is designed. Likewise, if somebody is giving knowledge, if your mother is just feeding something over a spoon, then you have to open your mouth. That is a conducive position, or an amicable position, or a collateral position. Somebody is giving you like this, then you are taking something with this. Somebody is giving you flowers, you are bringing a basket, okay. Somebody is pouring milk, can you bring the same basket? You have to bring a can. Likewise, it is known as positional integrity or positional collateralism. So if an acharya, if a person is giving, that is a mismatch which exists between people. There are good aspirants, really.